when we looked at this bill and we saw that you had put in on the majority side this endowment tax loophole for Ivy League elites, and you're doing it because elitist. So rather than creating tax loopholes and shelters for the elitists who don't need this benefit.
Order, and the gentleman from Pennsylvania, Mr. Boyle, is recognized.
I mentioned earlier how historic this is. This is now personally historic for me because for the first time in my life, I've been called an elitist. And I would like to thank the gentleman on the other side. I've never been considered that way before. Second, and more seriously, as I mentioned, as a first-generation student myself, I am well aware that the universities that I attended used a percentage of their endowments in order to provide the significant student aid I needed in order to attend those universities. If the gentleman is concerned that the cost of college is too high in this country, I completely agree with him. The fact that we have $1.8 trillion of student debt right now is a disaster, not only for the individuals in repayment, which happens to include myself, but I think on our economy. Keep in mind, however, the Republican endowment tax of 4 years ago did nothing, literally not one dime, to reduce the cost of a higher education. The 1.4% tax simply went to the government with absolutely no provision whatsoever incentivizing or requiring these universities to spend a certain percentage of their endowment on student aid. What is in this Democratic proposal does that. It doesn't eliminate the endowment tax, but it reforms it. It rewards those colleges and universities and gives them a credit based on the percentage of their endowment that they are using in order to invest in their students in terms of student aid. It is taking what frankly was a bad and clumsy Republican idea 4 years ago and reforming it to help incent those universities to do the right thing and reward those universities that are doing the right thing. So with that, I urge a no vote on the gentleman's amendment, and I extend my hand to anyone on the other side who sincerely wants to tackle this problem of the cost of college education in this country. With that, I yield back to the chairman.